The mother of double Olympic gold medalist Carlos Yulo finally faces the media to give her side on the controversy surrounding their family. In a video posted on social media on Tuesday, Yulo accused his mother of misusing his cash incentives in previous tournaments. Angelica Yulo said their rift has affected her and other family members, as she called on the public to give them privacy. Angelica Yulo, however, declined to comment on her son's girlfriend, whom the Olympian said is the root cause of their conflict.
Malaki yung naging effect, no? Hindi makatulog, yung eldest ko hindi nakakapasok, yung mga anak ko na parang hindi rin sila mapakali, no? Kasi lagi nilang hawak yung phone nila, tapos parang, syempre, pag may nababasa silang bad comment about me, mga anak ko, nasasaktan sila for me, no?
Walang inang, hindi namin isang ba ang anak niya. Lalo, matagal na panahon namin siyang hindi nakasama. Hindi lang naman po ako ang nakakamiss sa kanya, pati yung mga kapatid niya, namimiss siya ng papa niya.
The lawyer of Yulo's mother insists the money matters between the family should be left private.
Again, when it comes to the money matters issue, Mrs. Yulo will no longer respond to them. Let us respect the family's decision to keep it private. Again, all of these matters are matters between family members and we should leave it at that.
The city of Cagayan de Oro still at risk of losing water supply. President Marcos earlier tasked the Local Water Utilities Administration, or LUA, to solve the water crisis in the city after the Cagayan de Oro Water District failed to pay over 400 million pesos to Metro Pacific Water, which supplies majority of the water needs of the city. This led to MPC threatening to cut the province's or the city's water supply. LUA Chairman Ronnie Ong says despite the issue, officials of the water district remain uncooperative. He believes corruption is taking place in the local agency.
From 2018 to 2021, meron pong COA report na ang losses nila is 5.2 billion pesos. Ang non-revenue water po nila nasa 50% above. Ang nakakataka po, umutang po sila sa DBP tsaka sa LUA. And one of the conditions is to fix their non-revenue water of your leakage nila. From 2018 above, tumataas yung non-revenue water nila or yung leakage nila. So sana punta yung pera? 2022, 182 million. And then 2021, 352 million na funding within the agency, nagtatransfer po sila sa iba-ibang accounts. So nagsabi ang supplier nila, puputulan na daw sila. Nakialam po ang LUA in ways na nag-mediate po kami. Nagtawag po kami ng as many as 6 meetings. Mm-hmm. Very frustrating, hindi po sumisipot ang mga tao sa water district.
President Marcos inaugurates a climate change adaptation project which aims to protect low-lying areas in Pampanga from massive flooding. Our correspondent Gracie Rutao joins us for the details. Gracie, over to you.
Stanley, before that, the president was also in Mexico, Pampanga, to attend the turnover ceremony for the second tranche of the various operating and maintenance equipment of the National Irrigation Administration at Global Construct City in Mexico, Pampanga. During the ceremony, the president oversaw the turnover of 148 units of different equipment, including crawler excavators, tractor trucks, and dump trucks, with a total value of 782,988,000 pesos. These assets were distributed to various NIA offices across the country. The event underscored the government's commitment to enhancing agricultural productivity and improving irrigation systems across the country. The newly acquired equipment is expected to significantly enhance the maintenance and operation of irrigation facilities, benefiting farmers and agricultural stakeholders in the region. Key attendees included House Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez, Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Dong Gonzalez, DA Secretary Francisco Laurel Jr., NIA Administrator Engineer Eddie Guillen, Pampanga Governor Dennis Pineda, Vice Governor Lilia Pineda, and other local officials. The government's goal is to strengthen food security and improve the livelihoods of Filipino farmers. For Region 3, a total of 9 equipment were allocated. the President announced that the preparations are underway for the third tranche of operating and maintenance equipment for 2025 with a proposed budget of 1 billion pesos. The President was also in Masantol, Pampanga to inaugurate a major flood control mitigation project or the Stage 1 of the Integrated Disaster Risk Reduction and Climate Change Adaptation Project, which is seen to improve the flood resilience of the towns of Makabebe, Masantol, Minalin, and Santo Tomas. The 7.57 billion project was funded through the official development assistance from South Korea and aims to improve the river network and flood control infrastructure of the province through excavation, dredging, and widening of the river channels, as well as the construction of embankments to enhance flood control. The project also involves the construction of 3 new bridges, 5-foot bridges, 8 sluice gate structures, and 164 fish pond gates. In his speech, the President instructed DPWH to ensure that the second stage of the project will proceed as scheduled to fully realize the project's benefits and provide long-term solutions to flooding in Pampanga. He also assured that the government will expeditiously complete the ongoing flood control projects in Central Luzon. And that's the latest here in Pampanga. Back to you, Stanley.
Thanks a lot for that story, Gracie Rutao. And the two low-pressure areas over the northern Philippine Sea have merged. Now, it will continue to enhance the southwest monsoon. Let's now get an outlook on the weather from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Roas. Hi, Ariel.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. The two weather disturbances still linger around the Philippines. The low-pressure area just north of the Philippine area of responsibility merged with the other LPA inside the PAR. And the remaining system was located 550 kilometers northeast of Itbayat, Batanes, and has a low chance of developing into a tropical cyclone. However, the other LPA far northeast of the country outside the PAR developed into a tropical depression Tuesday evening. At 10 this morning, it was located more than 2,000 kilometers east-northeast of extreme northern Luzon with winds of 55 kilometers per hour and gusts up to 70 kilometers per hour. It is almost stationary at the moment, but it will move away from the country and intensify. The disturbances are weakly pulling the southwest monsoon or habagat. Occasional rain, especially in the morning, afternoon, and late night, are expected in Ilocos region, western Cordillera, central Luzon, especially Zambales and Bataan, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, Western Visayas, and Zamboanga Peninsula. Localized thunderstorms may also be experienced in Bicol, Negros, Samar, Northern Mindanao, Caraga, Sokcergen, and Barm. Metro Manila has low chance of rain throughout the day, but sudden afternoon downpour due to thunderstorm formation may still be possible. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Stanley.
All right, thank you so much for the update, Ariel Rojas.